Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Now celebrating 17 years of broadcasting success, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again, both for our radio audience here in the South and our online audience tuning in, thanks to our friends at iHeartRadio and Amazon Music Podcast. Glad you all could be with us as well. It's been 3 years since best-selling author John Hart has been on our program, but he is back with a brand-new book called The Unwilling. We're going to talk to John not only about the characters, but also what it was like for him to be able to play with the idea of good and bad and maybe what's in between and where all of us can be able to find something that we can enjoy in the latest thriller from him. John, thank you so much for the time. Really appreciate it.
Yes, Cyrus, absolutely. I appreciate your time.
So, John, here you've given us this great new book with Jason French, and I think what is so cool about Jason is that, you know, there are so many different layers of him. What was it like for you to explore as you were writing The Unwilling?
So, yeah, Jason is one of the best characters I've ever written, you know, inspired by a story of really exceptional courage during the Vietnam War. I became obsessed with this idea of courage regardless of cost. And you know, if we have time to talk about what, you know, that specific inspiration was, we can go there. But, you know, the idea of this character who, you know, will do whatever it takes without looking for justification or, you know, redemption from others. You know, he does these things for his own reasons. And so in writing him, it was really fun because so often when we write characters, we drop these little bits of information and the reader can assimilate them and they understand that character and they know that character, you know, whether he's good, bad, or in between. Jason was fun because as I built his character and delivered these bits of information about his life, the reader is really left wondering, you know, is this a good guy or a bad guy? I mean, he's so complex that we don't really know until the end of the book exactly who and what he is. And so that was really the fun of writing Jason, was creating this cipher for the readers that they just don't know whether to love him or hate him. And then by the end of it, I think it comes as a pretty awesome surprise who he really is.
Yeah. And I think the great thing about this, though, John, I think that is so true of all of us at some point, right? The people think they have an idea of who we are, but it really is up to us to show people who we are. You mentioned, of course, you know, about the character and how endearing he is for you. I mean, for yourself, you've had such a great career. I mean, storytelling, is that something you've always known, John, that you were kind of meant to do?
Well, I think so. The problem is nobody really draws a roadmap on how to succeed at this. I mean, I grew up reading, you know, I was one of these kids that would be up until 1 or 2 on a school night reading, you know, non-school work, right, fun books. And I outlined my first novel when I was 20. I wrote 2 failed novels, one in law school, one in a different graduate school. They never got agented or published. So I've always aspired to do this, but it's a rocky road to figure out the skill sets and the path. I call it my 15-year overnight success story. So to answer your question, yes, I've always wanted to do this. It was just a matter of learning how and finding the right way to do it.
Yeah. You know, we are able to get to know Jason French, another character that is intriguing, and we'll talk around him, John, is X. What was that like for you to create X and the complexities with that character?
Okay, so I'm going to give a little bit away about X. So,
okay.
So X is this mysterious prisoner in the most notorious prison in North Carolina, this really horrible place. And he lives in his own suite of cells underneath death row, and he's got this amazing power that he wields. He's incredibly wealthy. He's got, you know, fingers beyond the prison walls and levers that he can pull inside the prison walls, and he's kind of a spider at the center of his web, you know, pulling strings and manipulating people. You know, I call him the most dangerous man alive. He's violent. He's sadistic. He's brilliant. You know, and for whatever reason, he wants this character, Jason, back in prison. You know, Jason, who fought 3 tours in Vietnam, came home, got into gun running and heroin, and ended up on a 3-year stint. Somehow came across this prisoner X, and even when he's out at the beginning of the book, X wants him back. And so it was a fascinating character to write and to try to make him believable because he is so unusual and just so terrifying in so many ways. But a heck of a lot of fun to write.
Yeah, it was an interesting yin and yang, right? I mean, in the book, it seemed like the way that X looked at Jason, and almost like a completion of sorts, you know, someone that was a fitting, I think, a fitting rival for sure. It's interesting the way that plays out. You mentioned at the beginning of the conversation, John, and we're going to remind our audience, of course, how they can get the book, you know, about this whole idea for Jason and his journey, and then, of course, the title of the book, The Unwilling. You know, of course, your book tour is a little different this year because of the way that the world is. But what has it been like for you virtually already to be able to connect with your readers and to see the way they're responding to the book?
Well, I mean, look, I'll take what I can get in the time of COVID, right? But there's little substitute for a physical tour. Writing is a lonesome business. I spent about 16 or 18 months writing this novel. And it's always fun to get out on the road for 6 weeks, visit 30 or 40 cities and, you know, talk to the readers and be reminded in a visceral way why this matters. I mean, when people line up and, you know, spend their time and their money and they want to shake your hand and talk about the books, it reminds me why I really enjoy this, because it is about the reaction to story. It's not just about sitting alone and putting words on the page. You know, that said, the virtual tour is, I mean, look, it's viable. It's fun. I mean, I'm on with you now. I'll be on with others throughout the day, and then I get to do these great events with, like, John Grisham and Patricia Cornwell and C.J. Box and, you know, a lot of great writers that are making themselves available for the virtual tour. But there's no substitute for meeting the readers, because that's where you really see the passion for the books, and that kind of thing matters a lot.
And that's why we definitely want to encourage our audience, once you finish The Unwilling, make sure you guys head over to Amazon, write your review, let John know what you think about it, of course, as well as share it online as well. Again, everyone, best-selling author John Hart has been back on with us, talking with us about the literary journey and his newest book that is out now called The Unwilling. So make sure you guys pick it up either on Amazon or through your favorite local bookstore. And, John, how can they stay connected with you?
I'm not a huge social media guy, but I do try to share bits of my life with readers that are interested. So I have a website, johnhartfiction.com, and on Facebook and Instagram, it's John Hart Author. I have a Twitter presence, but I don't tweet a lot, so that would be a waste of time. But find me those other places, you know, join me on the road.
All right. Well, John, great catching up with you again. Thanks a lot for the time, and looking forward to speaking with you again.
Hey, thank you, Cyrus. Have a great day.
You as well. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying, as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live. Now let's go make today amazing. Take care.